with my next episode of Sunday Stories. And as you must have read the title, today's story is Do Good. We all know, and I have, I think, narrated and recited many stories where the theme is almost the same, that is, if you do good, good comebacks to you. What goes around comes around. Karma. And actually, I really believe in this, and I have seen in various phases of life, this is actually a reality. So today's story. There was a farmer, a very hard-working farmer, and his name was Fleming. He was very good at heart, very hard-working, sincere, and was working on his ground. He was doing his farming, and you know, when suddenly he heard a child crying, you know, some struggling and crying and moaning sound was heard by him. So he quickly, you know, ran out of his farm and, you know, started running here and there as to where that sound of moaning of a child was coming from. And he suddenly witnessed a swamp plant. What is a swamp plant? It is, as you call in Hindi, it is daldal. Alright, it is a ground which is very swampy and wetty. And often, you know, when the mud and water is a large amount of it is accumulated, people, there have been records, you know, where people have fallen into that and have not been able to come out, and they have died in this swamplands. So he was a small boy who had got stuck up there, and he was struggling to come out, but he was not able to do so. He was just a small kid of around 5 or 6 years of age, and he was moaning and struggling and crying for help. So, you know, as soon as this farmer saw him, he just couldn't stop, and he went into that swampland, and with great struggle and his strategy, because he was a farmer and he knew how to act when this sort of a thing happened. So he took that boy out and saw that that boy was so scared, so terrified, and was actually very in a very bad condition. So he carried him home and you know, he bathed him, gave him something to eat, relaxed him a lot, and then he told him to go back home, because he was worried that his parents must be looking for this child. So the day was over, but next day early in the morning, you know, he saw that a big, you know, royal carriage was standing in front of his house. So he quickly went towards his house from his farm and to find out who it was. And it was a very rich man of United Kingdom, and his name was Rudolph Churchill. He was a very wealthy and rich man, and he had come in his royal carriage to specially thank this farmer who had saved his son's life. So that means the child who was struggling in that swampland was Rudolph Churchill's son. So, you know, Fleming went up to him and asked who he was, and Rudolph Churchill was so very grateful. He thanked him for saving his son's life, and, you know, he said, "I have a lot of money, I have everything. You just tell me what you want in return. You have saved my life. You have saved my son." So Fleming said, "I didn't know he was your son, and whatever I did, it was on humanitarian ground. It was only humanity. I don't want anything in return." He said, "No, see, you have to take something or whatever you want. Just let me know what you want. You want money, you want a plot of land, or whatever you want. You want a house, whatever, because you have saved the life of my son. That is my life." So he just didn't know. Fleming said, I am a hardworking farmer, and by God's grace, I have everything that I need. I have a happy family. I have a son of the same age, and everything is fine with me. I don't want anything. So, you know, just then a small boy came running out. So Rudolf Churchill asked, is he your son? So Fleming said, yes. He said, all right. See, I want to thank you so much, and I want to do something for you. So his education will now be sponsored by me. I will sponsor his education, and he will study in the same school in which my son goes. So Fleming was, you know, just shocked and surprised, and it was such a good surprise. His son would study where in the school where the, you know, rich, wealthy people send their children to. So on a lot of insistence, you know, Rudolf Churchill actually insisted a lot, and he said, see, don't refuse now. Wherever my son will study, your son will study there only, and even for higher studies, whatever he wants to do, I will make him study that, your son, and whatever, you know, whichever college he wants to go, I will make him get educated there. So this was a really great thing that even Rudolf Churchill did for Fleming, who saved his son's life. And do you know, higher studies, school, they went to the same school, both the children, and higher studies by this Fleming's son was done in St. Mary's Medical College of London, which is regarded as the best medical college. Alright, and at that time it was the best in the world. So, and he grew up to be whom? We all have read and studied a lot about him. And he grew up to be Alexander Fleming. Alexander Fleming, the person who was the one who had invented penicillin, the antibiotic. He was the one who we have. I have a picture for you over here. It's this. Just a second. This is penicillin. This is a mold that he has made out of this. This is Alexander's penicillin, and it is the antibiotic. And he was the one who found out that if there was any infection in the body of human beings, then this antibiotic could be given and the person could recover. So he was Alexander Fleming. And do you know, Rudolf Churchill's son became very, very ill when he grew up, and it was at that time this penicillin had come out. All right. And so this Rudolf Churchill's son became very, very ill, and people came to know that he was so very ill that he would die of infection. And it was this Alexander Fleming's penicillin that was sent over there to cure Rudolf Churchill's son. And do you know who this person was? He was Winston Churchill. We all have read about Winston Churchill too. Who was? This is the picture of Winston Churchill, who became the Prime Minister of UK twice. Alright? See, we have heard so much, but you know, we don't know these stories behind whatever things happen. So just see, Fleming saved the life of Winston Churchill, right? Father. The Rudolf Churchill, Winston Churchill's father, wanted to return this great act. He educated Alexander Fleming, who later on invented penicillin. And that same penicillin was again used to save the life of Winston Churchill. what goes around comes around. Little more about Alexander Fleming, you know, he was such a great person. This penicillin was, this is the story, you know, when Fleming saved Rudolf Churchill's son, when Rudolf Churchill's son was small, that was 1887. This is the story of 1887. And this penicillin was invented by him in 1928 on the 28th of September. All right. And then, you know, there he became so famous, like magazine people and newspaper people were interviewing him, and people came to know that wounds and whatever infections were could be, you know, cured by this penicillin, this antibiotic. And we all know till date we are eating the antibiotics whenever we fall sick. Antibiotics are given to us, and the way we are, you know, cured, it is all we need to thank Alexander Fleming, who did this great invention. And you know, so many people started, you know, flooding in his house and for interviewing him and everything. And he was also given the Nobel Prize of Medicine in 1945. And you know, people came to him and they told him that, you know, if he could patent, you know, what is patenting? When you invent something and you give your name and you sell it, you can get crores and crores of rupees. Like, you can just become the richest people. But Alexander was so good at heart, so down to earth, that he said, no, I don't want my name or anything to get patented or anything. It's just for free. I have invented this and I'm happy that everybody is using it. And you will be you know, happy to know that these medicines, these antibiotics of penicillin, were different types of, you know, there were other types of things, you know, all based on penicillin. Many medicines came out, and they all were used to cure thousands and thousands of soldiers who got injured or unwell during the Second World War. And everyone regarded and thanked him, was grateful to him, just as we all are grateful to God. He was a godly person at that time, because he had taken out such a medicine, such an antibiotic that could cure all infections. Before that, there was no such cure. Isn't it really great? So we need to do good without thinking about ourselves. Fleming, the farmer, Alexander Fleming's father, had also done good by saving this little boy from the swampland. He did not think about his own life. He could have also got stuck up there, but he saved the life of this person without knowing that he was a son of a rich man. And later on, his son got the best education maybe he could not have given, being a farmer. All right. And yes, because, you know, educating in the St. Mary's Medical College of London is a great thing. And then he was such a good student, such a good scientist, that he was able to take out this medicine, which later on saved the life of Winston Churchill and many other soldiers and people. And it is still saving our lives. What goes around comes around. So keep doing good. We'll meet you next Sunday with yet another story. Till then, take care of yourself. Goodbye.